Today session we can discuss about multiplication of integers. Multiplication of a positive and a negative integer. So multiplication of whole number is represented addition. We already learned about this, so you can see example 5 plus 5 plus 5, it will be 3 into 5 is equal to 15. Here we took 3 because we wrote 5 at 3 times. So simple form of addition is multiplication. So this 5 plus 5 plus 5 will be written as 3 into 5. So we know that 5 threes are 15. Okay, then we can see by help of the number line with the integers. So we have from the following number line, from this, so minus 5 plus minus 5 plus minus 5. So we adding these 3 digits, we will get minus 15. These are the negative numbers. So sum of negative numbers will be a negative number. So minus 5 plus half minus 5 plus half minus 5 will be minus 15. And then we can observe this number line. On this number line, 0's left side is negative digits. So minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5. So minus 5, minus 6, minus 7, minus 8, minus 9, minus 10, and so on. So but we can also write using a number line. Therefore, minus 5 plus half minus 5 plus half minus 5 will be represent as 3 into minus 5, because minus 5 repeat at 3 times, so that will be written as 3 into minus 5. So then 3 into minus 5 will be minus 15, because 5 threes are 15, and then here 3 plus positive sign, so 3 into minus 5 become minus 15, plus into minus is minus. So by observing this, we can say that multiplied integers as positive into negative. So positive integer into a negative integer. So then we can see about negative into positive. So example, so given example is minus 2 into 5 equal to minus 10. So minus 2 is the negative integer and 5 is the positive integer. 5 2s are 10, so minus into plus will be minus. So second example, minus 3 into 5 is minus 15. Okay, so here we multiplied integer as negative integer into positive integer. Okay, so here minus 2 and minus 3 are the negative integers and 5 are the positive integers. So while multiplying a positive integer and a negative integer, we multiply them as a whole number and then put a minus sign before the product. We thus get the negative integer. So here minus we wrote before the product, which is a 10 and 15. Okay, so next we can see the general form of any two positive integers considered as a and b. We can say that a into of minus b or a minus a into b will be written as minus of a into b. It is a general form of multiplication of two integers. Then multiplication of two negative integers. So here minus 3 and minus 1 is both negative, so its product will be 3, because minus into minus is plus, so 3 ones are 3. Here also minus 3 and minus 2 are two negative integers, so minus into minus will be plus, 3 twos are 6. Here also same, minus into minus will be plus, 3 threes are 9. So here by observing these three examples, we can say that multiply the two negative integers as whole numbers and put the positive sign before the product. In general, for any two positive integers a and b, so here minus a into minus b equal to a into b. So according to given this sentence, we can say that multiply the two negative integers like minus 3 and minus 3. as a whole number. So 3 3s are 9. 3 is a whole number and this 3 is a whole number. 3 3s are 9. We wrote that 9. And then put the positive sign before the product. So 9 is 0. Here we not wrote any sign, but we have to consider as the positive sign, which is a plus 9. Okay. So then next we can move for a product of 3 or more negative integers. So first we observe this two negative integers, which are minus 4 into minus 3 will be minus into minus plus, and 4 3 is a 12. Then it will be 3 integers. Then we can consider minus 4, minus 3 and minus 2. So here multiplying negative sign at 3 times, minus into minus into minus. So minus into minus is a plus. Then we get plus here in between these two. Then plus into minus is a minus. Okay, like that we observe here minus 4 into minus 3 will be plus 12. We wrote here 12, and here minus 2 remain in this step. So 12 into minus 2, it will be plus into minus minus 12 to the 24. Okay, this is about when the given integers are 3. So if it is 4, so here minus into minus into minus into minus. So in this situation, we take this as a minus 4 into minus 3 into minus 2. So minus into minus into minus. So minus into minus is plus, plus into minus is minus. So 4 3 is 12, 12 2 is 24. Already we got in previous problem. So that minus 24 you write as it is. So this one more step remain, which is into minus 1. So write in front of this minus 24 into minus 1. So minus into minus is plus. So 24 ones are 24. We will get a positive number. So by observing these three examples, we can say that the product of two negative integer is positive integer, and the product of three negative integer is a negative integer, and the product of four negative integer is a positive integer. Okay. So then here product of two negative integer is a positive integer, the product of three negative integer is a negative integer, and the product of four integer is always will get a positive integer. In this problem, we can conclude that when we multiplying a negative sign at even time, we'll get positive integer. When we multiplying negative integers at odd time, we'll get negative integer. So if the number of negative integers in a product is even, then the product is a positive integer. If the number of negative integers in product is odd, then the product is a negative integer. Understood, students? So then we can move for next properties of multiplication of integers. So in closer under multiplication, see a statements, which is minus 20 into minus 5 equal to 100. So here minus 20 and minus 5 both are negative integers. So product of these two is 100, which is positive integer. So product is an integer, 100 also integer. So you can say that product is an integer. So minus 15 into 17. So minus 255 will get. Okay, so product of minus 15 and 17 is minus 255. So this is also integer. So you can say that product is an integer. By observing these two examples, we can say that the product of two integer is again an integer. So integers are close under multiplication. So in general, a into b is an integer for all integers a and b. So here we can say that a into b equal to c. So if you multiplying any two integers, you will get integer only. Okay, so then we can take a commutative of multiplication. So in commutative of multiplication, we can say example. First one is 3 into minus 4 will be minus 12. So 4 3s are 12, and plus into minus is minus 12. In second statement, we can interchange the terms. Minus 4 and 3. So first we wrote minus 4, then minus plus 3. So minus 4 into 3 will be minus 12. We got same product, but a term are interchanged. This will be written as 3 into of minus 4 is equal to minus 4 of into 3. By observing this example, the above example, multiplication is commutative for integers. So in general, we can write this as, in general, for any two integers a and b is a into b equal to b into a. So here consider a as a 3 and b as a minus 4. So this product is, we got minus 12, and here again we wrote b first and a is second. So this product also minus 12. By observing this example, we can say that a into b equal to b into a. So then multiplication by 0. So products of negative integers and 0 is 0. So if you are multiplying any negative integers to 0, we'll get 0 only. So minus 3 into 0 is 0, and 0 into minus 4 is 0. In general, for any integer a into 0 equal to 0 into a equal to 0. By observing this, we can say that any number we multiply to 0, or 0 is multiplied to any number, maybe integer or a whole number, the product will get the 0 only. Next, we can move for multiplicative identity. So we already learned in previous classes also, in that we learned that 1 is the multiplicative identity for a whole number. So then we can check for integers now. So minus 3 is an integer into 1. So minus 3 into 1 is minus 3, and 1 into 5 is 5. So by observing these two examples, this shows that 1 is the multiplicative identity for integers. So in general, for any integer a, we have a into 1 is equal to 1 into a. It will be a. It means if you multiplying any number to 1, we'll get itself number. So here we can say that 0 is the additive identity, where as 1 is the multiplicative identity for integers. We get additive inverse of an integers a when we multiply minus 1 to a, that is a into minus 1 equal to minus 1 into a, will get minus a. Okay, so then we can move for associativity for multiplication. So then the product of three integers does not depends upon the grouping of integers, and this is called as associative property for multiplication of integers. You can see example in this minus 3 into minus 2 into 5. We group in this first two terms. In next step, we group second and third terms. So here if you group, first you have to simplify, which is in square bracket. So minus 3 into minus 2 will be 6, because minus into minus is plus, 3 to the 6. This into 5 we wrote as it is. So 6 into 5 is 30. 6 5 is 30. But in second step, we group as minus 2 into 3 in a square bracket. So minus 3 we can write as it is. So minus 2 into 5 is minus 10, because minus into minus plus is minus 2 5 is 10. It will be written as minus 3 into minus 10. So here minus into minus is plus we get, and 10 5 3 is 30 will get. Okay, 30. So here also we got 30, here also we got 30. So by observing these answers, we can say that square of minus 3 into minus 2 into 5, it will be equal to minus 3 into of minus 2 into 5. So in general, for any three integers a, b and c, a into b into c equal to a into of b into c. here just we group in a different order. First two we group as the first term and second term. In RHS side we group second and third term. Okay, this is shows that associativity of multiplication. And then we can move for distributivity property. So then we can take example minus 2 into of 3 plus 5 equal to minus 2 into 8 equal to minus 16. So this will be considered as a LHS. So here minus 2 is a 3 is a B, plus 5 is a C. So here what we did, 3 plus 5, we adding this common bracket terms which are 3 and 5, will get 8, minus 2 wrote as it is. So minus 2 into 8 will be 16, because 8 2s are 16, this minus sign is there, so minus into plus is minus, minus 16 we got. So in the next term, we wrote this as minus 2 into 3 plus minus 2 into 5. So this we took A into B and then A into C. So this product minus 2 into 3 is minus 6 and minus 2 into 5 is minus 10. So minus 6 plus minus 10 will be minus 16. So by observing these two answers, both product we got as a minus 16. So we can say that minus 2 into 3 plus 5 is equal to minus 2 into 3 plus minus 2 into 5. So distributivity of multiplication over addition is true for integers also. So in general, for any integers a, b and c, we can say that a into of b plus c is equal to a into b plus a into c. So then we can take one more example. So minus 5 into of minus 4, minus 5 into minus 4, minus half minus 6 is equal to, so here first we'll write this minus 5 as it is. So minus 4 minus half minus 6, so minus into minus 6 plus, will get minus 4 plus 6 will be 2. So minus 5 into 2 is minus 10. Okay, don't get confused, here minus 4 is there, here minus half minus 6 is there. So first we'll simplify, which is in common bracket, minus into minus will be plus, so plus 6 it is, so this is minus 4. Minus 4 plus 6 become 2, because 6 is the biggest number we get and its sign will be plus when you multiplying minus into minus. So next step, minus 5 into of minus 4, this 2 product is minus into minus is plus, 5 4s are 20, we wrote 20 here. And then next here minus 5 into minus 6, so minus into minus once again become, so minus into minus is plus, 5 6 are 30, correct. So here this in between that sign is negative, so 20 minus 30 is minus 10. So minus 5 into minus 4 minus half minus 6 equal to minus 5 into minus 4 minus half minus 5 into minus 6. So observing this, you can say that distributivity of multiplication over subtraction is true for integers. In general, for any three integers a, b and c, is a into of b minus c equal to a into b minus a into c. So next you can solve exercise 1.3. in this question 1, find each of the following products. So 3 into minus 1. So like this given questions from A to J. So 3 into minus 1. Here 3 into 1 is 3 and plus into minus is minus 3. Okay. So B1, minus 1 into 225. So 225 into 1 is 225. So minus into plus is minus 225. Okay. And then minus 21 into minus 30. So just 21 3s are 63. So this 0 we write afterwards. So minus to minus is plus. So totally minus 21 30s are 630. And then here 316 into 1 is 316. So minus into minus is plus. So then 15 into 0 is 0, then 0 into 18 is 0. Okay, so multiplying any number to 0 will get 0 only, or 0 to any number will get 0 only. So then f1 minus 12 into minus 11 into 10. So minus 12 into minus 11 is 132, because minus into minus is plus. So 12 11s are 132. So 132 into 10 is
1320.
So then here 9 into minus 3 into minus 6. So first we multiply this minus into minus is plus. 6 3s are 18. Then 18 9s are 162. Okay. Then here minus 18 into minus 5 into minus 4. So minus into minus is a plus. 18 5s are 90. Then 90 into minus 4. So 90 into 4 is 360. So this plus into minus is minus 360. So then here minus 1 into minus 2 into minus 3 into 4. So minus into minus is plus. Then plus into this minus is minus. 1 2s are 2. 2 3s are 6. So minus 6 into 4. So minus into plus is minus. 6 4s are 24. Can move for second question. Verify the following. 81 question has 18 into 7 plus of 18 into minus 3. So this is the first question. And minus 21 into minus 4 plus of minus 6 equal to minus 21 into minus 4 plus of minus 21 into minus 6. Second question. First solve first question, which is 18 into 7 plus of minus 3. And 18 into 7 plus 18 into 3. This is just written as a into of b plus c equal to a into b plus a into c. So first we'll solve this 18 into 4, because 7 plus of minus 3 is equal to 4. This is plus into minus is minus. 7 minus 3 is 4 we get. So 18 into 4. And here 18 sevens are 126, and 18 into minus 3 is minus 54. So 18 4s are 72 we got here, and here 126 minus 54 is 72. By observing this answer, we can say that LHS equal to RHS, so hence verify. Then B question, minus 21 into of minus 4 plus of minus 6, which is LHS side. RHS side is given minus 21 into minus 4 plus of minus 21 into minus 6. So here minus 21 right as it is. This minus 4 and minus 6 both are negative numbers. It will be written as minus 10. And this minus into minus is a plus. 21 4s are 84. And here minus into minus is a plus. 21 6 are 126. So then here minus into minus is a plus. 21 10s are 210. 84 plus 126 is 210. So by observing these two answers, we can say that LHS equal to RHS. So hence verified. Next we move for question number 3. For any integer a, what is minus 1 into a equal to? And second question, determine the integer whose product with minus 1 is minus 22, 37 or c 0. So a1 we can solve. Minus 1 into a is minus a, because minus into plus is a minus. So a will be written as it is. So where a is an integer. Yes. Then second main first one. Minus 1 into minus 22 will get 22. And minus 1 into 37 will get minus 37. So minus 1 into 0 is 0. So we can say that the product also an integers.
Thank you, students. Next class we can discuss from question number 4.